God, I know that you have sent me here on a mission, and I pray that this will become a happy family in thy sight. God bless Liesl and Friedrich, Brigitte, Luisa, Marta, and little Gretel, and, oh, I forgot his name, but God bless what's his name. God bless Mother Abbess and the sisters at Nonberg Abbey. And dear God, about Liesl, help her to know that I'm her friend, and help her to tell me what she's up to.
I was out taking a walk, and somebody locked the doors earlier than usual. I didn't want to wake everybody up, so when I saw your window open, I... You're not going to tell Father, are you?
Liesl, were you out there walking all by yourself? You know, if we wash out that dress tonight, no one will notice it tomorrow, and all of this could just be between you and me. Here, put this on and go in the bathtub and put that dress to soak. And come back here and we'll have a little talk.
I told you today that I didn't need a governess. Well, maybe I do.
Oh, Gretel, it's you. Are you afraid? Come, all of you, up on the bed. Now, all we have to do is wait for the boys.
We won't see them. Boys are brave.
You boys aren't frightened too, are you?
No, we just wanted to be sure that you weren't.
Friedrich, was this your idea?
No, it was Kurt's.
Kurt, that's his name. God bless Kurt!
Why does it do that?
Well, the lightning says something to the thunder, and the thunder answers it back.
I wish it wouldn't answer so loud.
Well, maybe if we all sing loud enough, we won't be able to hear it. Now, just imagine. High on the hill was a lonely goatherd, lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da-lay-a-da folks in a town that was quite remote heard lay oodle lay oodle lay hoo. Last in clear from the goat herd throat heard lay oodle lay oodle loo.
Oh ho, lady oodle lay, ho, oh ho, lady oodle lay, oh ho, lady oodle lay, oh lady oodle lay, oh lay.
One little girl in a pale pink coat heard lay oodle lay oodle lay hoo. She oodled back to the lonely goat herd lay oodle lay oodle loo. Soon her mama with a gleaming load heard lay oodle lay oodle lay hoo. What a duet for a girl and goat herd lay oodle lay oodle loo.
Oh ho, lady oodle lay, oh oh ho, lady oodle lay, oh ho, lady oodle lay, oh lady oodle lay, oh lay.
Happy are they, lady oh, lady lady oh, oh lady oh, lady lady oh. Soon the duet will become a trio, lay oodle lay oodle loo. Oodle lay.
While we're having coffee out here? Any sign of the children?
Georg, those mountains, they're magnificent.
Yes, they're not like any other mountains. They're friendly. You see those green stretch of woods over there? When the wind blows through, it's just like a restless sea.
And that sweet little village.
That's not a village, that's a town.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt its feelings.
You know, it's fun being with you. You're quite an experience for me.
You're quite an experience for me, too. Somewhere in you, there's a fascinating man. Occasionally, I catch a glimpse of him. And when I do, he's exciting.
Exciting? I don't think anyone has ever called me exciting before.
I'm beginning to understand you better now that I see you here. No, you're a little like those mountains, except that you keep moving. How can you be away from this place as you are?
Maybe I'm just searching for a reason to come back home and stay.
Georg, I like it here very much.
Max can't still be on the telephone, can he? You like it here?
Oh, we'd have to spend some time in Vienna. I have Heinrich's estate to look after.
I thought that was a corporation.
It is, and I'm president.
You? President of a corporation?
Years before he died.
I just can't imagine you sitting behind a desk.
I'm sorry I took so long.
Any luck?
How would you like this for the Salzburg Festival? The finest choral group in Austria. The greatest mixed quartet in Europe. And the best soprano in the world.
Max, that's something I'd love to hear.
So would I.
You know, Georg,
I like rich people. I like the way they live. I like the way I live when I'm with them. What's that?
Oh, that's the Abbey, Nürnberg Abbey.
Do they have a choir?
A beautiful one.
Good. In the next few days, I have to visit all these towns around here and listen to their choirs, quartets.
I'm sure you'll be here for the meals, won't you?
Oh, yes.
You know, Georg, I'd like to meet all your friends. Why don't you give a dinner for me while I'm here? Nothing very much. Just something lavish.
I wouldn't know whom to invite. Nowadays, it's hard to tell who's a friend and who's an enemy.
This isn't a time to make enemies. Let's make some friends.
I can't understand what could have happened to the children.
You're not worried about them, are you?
They should have been here to welcome you.
It couldn't have been an intentional slight. They haven't even met me yet.
Please, forgive me. I'll try and find them.
Elsa, have you made up Georg's mind yet? Is he going to marry you?
Oh, yes. He hasn't admitted it yet. Seems to be something standing in his way.
You don't know what it is?
No.
I do.
What?
It's simple. It's money.
Money?
Yes. He's rich, and you're rich.
In all the famous love affairs, the lovers have to struggle. In garret rooms away upstairs, the lovers starve and snuggle. They're famous for misfortune, which they seem to have no fear of. And lovers who are very rich, you very seldom hear of.
No little shack does he share with me. We do not flee from a mortgagee. Nary a care in the world have we. How can love survive? He's fond of bonds and he owns a lot. I have a plane and a diesel yacht. Plenty of nothing we haven't got. How can love survive? No rides for us on the top of a bus in the face of the freezing breezes.
You reach your goal in your comfy old Rolls.
Warm in one of my Mercedes. Far, very far off the beam are we. Quaint and bizarre as a team are we. 2 millionaires with a dream are we. We're keeping romance alive. 2 millionaires with a dream are we.
Survive.
want? Who are you?
I am Herr Detweiler.
Well, you've delivered your telegram. Now get out.
Georg, he's just a boy.
And I'm Austrian. I will not be heard.
Georg, why don't you look at things the way I do? What's going to happen is going to happen. Just be sure it doesn't happen to you. Thank you, Franz. Excuse me, Georg. Elsa?
Get cleaned up, get into your uniforms, at once! Fräulein, where did you get those abominations from? Out of a nightmare?
No, out of some old curtains that used to hang in my room. They still had plenty of wear left in them.
Just a moment. You mean to say that my children have been seen by the neighborhood wearing old curtains?
Yes, they've become very popular. They all say, there go Captain Von Trapp's children.
My children have always been a credit to my name.
But they weren't. They were just unhappy little marching machines.
I don't get to hear from you about my children.
Well, you've got to hear it from someone. You're not home long enough to know
them. I still don't want
to
hear
it. I know you don't, but you've got to. Take Liesl. Liesl isn't a child anymore. If you keep treating her as one, you're going to have a mutiny on your hands. And Friedrich, he's shy. He's aloof. He needs your confidence.
Don't you tell me about my son.
Brigitte could tell you about him. She could tell you a lot more if you got to know her because she notices things. And she always tells the truth, especially when you don't want to hear it. And Marta, I haven't finished yet. Marta, she just wants to have a good time. Oh, please, Captain, let her have a good time. Louisa, I don't know about yet, but someone's got to find out about her. Kurt, he's sensitive, he's easily hurt, and you push him aside the way you do all of them. Little Gretel, she just wants to be loved. Oh, please, Captain, love Gretel. Love all of them. They need you.
Stop, stop it. You will pack your things and report back to the Abbey as soon as possible.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said those things.
After you're gone, they'll be...
The hills are
singing?
Why, yes, I know it's
singing. With the sound of
your children.
Music.
Singing.
Georg, you must hear me.
With songs they have sung.
Children, I'd like for you to meet Baroness Schrader. Would you kindly show it to the gardens, please?
Yes, do show me the gardens. And I'd love to hear you all sing another song. Who taught you to sing so beautifully?
Fräulein Maria.
And she taught me to play the guitar.
You were right, Fräulein. I don't know my own children.
They're waiting to know you. After I'm gone...
No, no. I want you to stay.
If I can be of any help.
You've already helped enough. You've brought music back to my home.
That's the lane there.
Can you show me it, please?
I hadn't danced since I was really little. I'm not sure if I remember.
Oh, you remember it. You said left hand behind the back.
But first, the boy and girl must meet. And then they go for a little stroll.
Let's try again.
No, no, Kurt. That's wrong. Let me show you.
I remember anymore.
Well, Kurt, That's how it's done. Excuse me.
Your face is all red.
Is it? Guess I'm not very used to dancing.
I think it's because Father's in love with you.
No, Brigida, you mustn't say things you don't know are true. Have you seen your father? I think it's very important that you kids like Baroness Schrader.
Why?
Well, I think she's going to be your new mother.
Oh no! Remember the other night when we were all singing the Eldevi song Father taught us? You laughed at him for forgetting the words. He didn't forget the words. He just stopped singing to look at you.
No, Brigida.
And the way you looked at him just now when you were dancing, you're in love with him too. Father, I don't think those people are having a very nice time.
No, darling. You see, one half of the town is angry at the other half. I thought maybe having a party would help, but now I'm not so sure.
Fräulein Maria! You're not having dinner with the children tonight. You're having dinner here with us.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. But you must put on another dress. Maria, wear the one you wore the other night when we were all singing. It was lovely.
Shall I have dinner, Captain?
Oh, no. Not yet. The children went to say goodnight.
No, no, not here.
Who did they take for me? This is so sweet.
No, Olsen, not in front of strangers.
Please, Georg.
Strangers? We're Austrian. Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Before we go into dinner, the Von Trapp children would like to say goodnight, as only they can.
Thank you.
Elsa, they're extraordinary. I've been looking all over Austria for something like this for the festival, and I find it here.
Wait a minute, Max.
A singing group of 7 children in one family.
Max, Eric didn't even want them to sing in front of the guests tonight. I had to persuade him.
Then you have influence. You must talk to him.
Max.
Elsa, this is important to Austria, and it wouldn't do me any harm.
Well, bless you, my daughter.
Maria's asked to see you. I know it has taken her a long time.
Yes, I waited until she wanted to come to see me.
It's strange. She's happy to be here, but she's unhappy too.
Why did they send her back? Do you know?
She doesn't speak except in prayer.
I'll see her now.
Libby.
Down, Maria. This must have been a trying experience for you. It was, Reverend Mother.
Has it taught you anything?
I learned that I never want to leave these walls again.
Why did they send you back to us?
They didn't send me back. I left. I was frightened.
Frightened?
I never felt that way before, and I knew that here, I'd be away from it all. Here, I'd be safe.
Maria, our abbey is not to be used as an escape.
But I can't face him again. Those feelings.
With Captain Von Trapp?
Brigida said that I was, and that her father was in love with me, but I was there on God's errand, and to ask for the captain's hand would have been wrong of me.
The love between a man and a woman is holy, too. What you must find out is, how does God want you to spend your love?
I've pledged my life to God's service.
If you love this man, it does not mean that you love God less. You must find out. You must go back.
Oh no, Reverend Mother.
These walls are not built to shut out problems. You have to face them. You have to find the life you were born to live.
But how do I find it?
Look for it.
Climb every mountain, search high and low, follow every byway, every path. Every day of your life.